I'm Mickey Martinson, and I made this floating planter to bring a bit of Disney magic to the backyard.
If you've ever been to EPCOT at Walt Disney World in Orlando, you may have noticed circular floating flower planters in some of the ponds there. We are going to make them for ourselves. My parents live on a lake that this would be absolutely perfect for, and my mom's birthday is coming up soon, so now's the time. And unlike other theme park at home projects, for this one, Disney published a book with step-by-step instructions. It's pretty easy. We glued together four styrofoam circles, two solid ones for the bottom, and two hollow ones for the top. Then we lined the inside with capillary matting, which is like felt and wicks water from the lake up into the soil. So it's self-watering. I'm going to deviate from the book in two significant ways. One, this isn't a small backyard pond, it's more of a lake. So I'm going to need a way to deploy the planter and bring it back for maintenance. So I'll be throwing out an anchor with a loop of cord through it. A line will go from the loop to the float, so I can bring it back in as though pulling on a clothesline. Two, I'm going to need a hot wire cutter with a rotary stage on it, so I can cut out the styrofoam circles I need. So let's get started. Like most hot wire cutters out there, this one is going to look more or less like a bandsaw, but instead of a blade, we'll have a thin nichrome wire, under tension and heated by passing a current through it. I'm using birch plywood for this project, 3/4 inch thick. Here I'm making a table for the cutter. I need a slit in the table for the hot wire to pass through, so I'm going to do that on my table saw by first lowering the blade all the way down, then raising it up through the wood. It's the same way you'd make a zero clearance insert. Clamping this firmly down is absolutely essential, but it took some figuring out. For the rotary stage, I'm going to use a 12-volt DC motor with worm gear reduction. I salvaged it from the trash. It has an output hub that's sort of like an inside-out splined shaft. To use that with the rotary table, I'm designing and 3D printing this adapter. Here's the motor I was talking about. It stacks up nicely using a thinner piece of plywood as a standoff. The PVC conduit clamp is almost tight enough around the motor to hold it, but a bit of sheet rubber wrapped around it can make this work. I'm using a hole saw to cut a round plug out of the table. That plug will become the rotary stage and will be motorized from underneath. These three wood screws are spikes that will transmit torque to the foam sheet. Now I have to make the yoke across which the hot wire will be stretched. For this I'll be using more of the same plywood, and also some of these 80/20 aluminum scraps. Rigging a thin nichrome wire isn't easy. I'm going to try capturing it between washers at both ends. These aluminum strips will give me a bit of adjustability. I'm going to feed the wire through a tiny hole in the bottom strip and tension it with a weight.
Never had one lesson.
Now for the electrical part of this. I'm not going to show the details of how I wired it, because frankly, it's a mess, and I don't want anyone copying it and getting into trouble. Sorry about that. What I will say is that I'm using a 12-volt switch mode power supply with a cheap PWM speed controller for this motor. Here I'm playing with the speed and direction controls. Depending on how big you cut your rough, getting this exactly in the middle isn't necessary. It just has to be close. And with that, finally, we can start cutting. We are melting plastic. We are making fumes. That's why I'm doing this close to an open garage door. I'm wearing a 3M respirator with cartridges approved for organic vapor, and I've got a box fan running to clear out the fumes even faster. You should do the same. Here I'm cutting the second disc. I begin roughing it out by cutting the corners off. Then I put it on the turntable. There's a big problem with my quick and dirty cutting yoke design. It's that piece of aluminum that rests on the table there, and more generally, the throat just isn't deep enough. That means I can only cut a pretty thin slice off the blank with each pass. Obvious room for improvement here. Off camera, I cut the inside out of two of the discs. Because of the throat problem, I wasn't able to use the hot wire cutter for this. I used a coping saw. But it's the inside of the planter, so the rough cut won't show. I also glued the discs together. Now I'm painting the whole thing with flat black exterior latex. Weirdly, the Disney Gardens book suggests spray paint for this, but normal spray paint melts styrofoam, so I wouldn't try it. Here I'm drilling a hole for the capillary wick. I need to cut a circle out of this felt material to line the inside of the planter. This rectangle is going to hang down into the lake through the hole in the planter and wick up the water. Now it's time to work on the rigging. I'm making a loop out of this cord and attaching a line from the loop to the float. Of course I need to keep checking my phone for instructions. I don't remember these knots. ¶¶ Mom loved it, so much so that she went to the plant store the same day, and we deployed it the day after that. Unfortunately, because of the rush, I don't have any video of it. So why isn't it in the water now? This is what happened. I had originally tied the float line to this stainless steel eye bolt, attached to the planter by a nut and a washer. That was fine, but I failed to account for the fact that the whole planter, under the influence of the wind and the waves, would be rotating. So it spun itself off of the nut, the eye bolt fell out, and the planter ended up down the shore somewhere. We recovered it, so let's try again. Off camera, I 3D printed these bushings. It occurred to me that the eye bolt, if it moves at all, will eventually wear out the styrofoam hole. So instead I'm going to glue the bushings in, thread the line through, and tie a stopper knot on the other side. Now let's find that nut. It's like it never happened. Now just pull on the cord to send it out there. And there it is after it's had a chance to grow in a bit. I particularly like how the greenery has reached the water's edge, just like in the EPCOT example. This project overall had a whole lot of what not to do in it, but I'll probably end up revisiting it sooner or later. After all, it's the kind of thing that looks better when there's more than one of them.